But the truth of the matter is, faith in God has gotten me some things that I can't even put my hands on. It got me some things that I can't even buy with a credit card. That I can't even put it in a bank account. Yeah, somebody said, this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me.
Do you believe, and you'll hold your hand, do you believe, and you'll fight your battle.
just believe it. Why don't you just give God some praise? Listen to me. Y'all think about this. The passage says he dwelt in the land. The land of promise as a foreigner. So he was in the land that was his. But he dwelt there as a foreigner. And he said, with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So what does that mean? The fulfillment of the promise didn't happen in his lifetime.
Right.
He died with the promise not yet fulfilled. But you gotta understand this. You got Abraham, you got Isaac, you got Jacob. Then after Jacob, you got Joseph. And Joseph ends up in Egypt. And everybody ends up coming to Egypt in the family. And then there arises a Pharaoh that knows not Joseph. Puts him in slavery. And God raises up Moses to be their deliverer. Delivers them out of Egypt. They wandered in the wilderness for 40 years. And Joshua is the one who leads them in the promised land. But the land was promised all the way back to Abraham. I'm saying to somebody, some of the things God has promised, the fulfillment of them, you might not get to see. But just because you don't see it don't mean it ain't gonna happen. Some stuff God's gonna fulfill through your children. I wish y'all hear me. Some stuff he's gonna fulfill through your grandchildren. Some stuff he's gonna fulfill at your church after he's gone. But he's telling you now to make a move. Because I want you to be a part of what I'm doing. You might not get to see all of it. But God uses you to be a part of a promise that he's going to see. Remember what Dr. King said? He said, I understand, you know, everybody wants to live forever. He said, longevity has its place. He said, I'm not going to get to go there with you. He said, but I've been to the mountaintop. I wish y'all hear what I'm saying. I've seen the promise of it. Some places God has you on a journey to, the people who get there, you might not be with the people, but the only reason they'll be able to get there is because he got you to make a move. I'm talking to you, and I'm saying, in this season, in this life, in this time, even in our ministry, in our church, God is challenging us to make moves by faith. I wish y'all hear me. And some of the stuff we're doing now, we're not going to get to see it happen. You're not going to get to see it happen. But it's going to happen. And some of it's going to happen because you moved by faith. I wish y'all hear what I'm saying. Some of the things in your children, I'm talking to somebody now. Some of the stuff you're doing now, you're doing it because your mama prayed. And mama been dead and gone. And God's still answering mama's prayer. And she in the grave, daddy in the grave. But the prayer they prayed, and they didn't even get to see it happen. God's making it happen right now. Come on, somebody just ought to be able to praise God for that right now. And I'm talking to somebody right now. God is telling somebody, it's time to make moves in your life. By faith, I know you don't have all the answers. I know you don't understand it all. But if God says go, if God says do it, let him figure the rest out. I don't know who I'm talking to, but I know I'm talking to somebody. Because God I ain't just preaching up here because I like to hear myself talk. I don't just get up and preach because I ain't got nothing else to do. But I believe God had a word for somebody today. Every time, I believe God wants to speak to somebody. The Bible says his word will not return to him, Lord. Every time it's sent out, is going to accomplish. Maybe the accomplishment is not seen immediately, but a seed is planted. And somebody, you're going to have to go all week thinking about the move you need to make, the thing God is telling you to do. Talk to somebody right now. Trust God on his time. On his time. Trust God on his time. Because he knows what's best. Anybody know if there's some information, if God told it to you, you wouldn't know what to do with it anyway? Some stuff, if God would have told you, you wouldn't have went. Because some stuff you can't handle no one. You weren't ready to know that. You couldn't handle that. It was too much for you. So God said, just come on by. Come on by. Come on by. All right, but those are churches. Those are churches.